neuron. So it is carrying the pain and temperature sensation, gross touch and the gross pressure sensation. Okay, now it will relay in the here in the posterior horn. Where it will relay, you know this thing. Now see, from the posterior horn, the second order neuron will begin. Now the second order neuron, they will cross the midline and they will run to the opposite side as the lateral and the ventral spinothalamic tract, isn't it? So which is carrying the pain and temperature, they forms the lateral, which is carrying the gross touch and the pressure, so that forms the anterior. You know this thing. Okay, now let me draw the spinotactile tract also. Now so suppose this is the fiber carrying the exterior receptive information, so that is the tactile stimuli, thermal stimuli, pain and all. Okay, thus they will relay here and it will cross the midline and it will run up, but it will not go to the thalamus. Okay, it will relay in the superior colliculus of the midbrain here. Now see here, so similarly there is a two are there, isn't it? The spinothalamic tract, lateral and anterior. Okay, now see, can you see this bundle together? So actually this spinotactile tract, it lies between midway between the two spinothalamic tract. So now the bundle, so the bundle of the axon of the second order neuron together, that is of lateral anterior spinothalamic tract and the spinotactile tract together, called as the spinal lemniscus. Spinal lemniscus. Are you getting? So it consists of the fiber of, that is the anterior spinothalamic tract plus posterior, not posterior, lateral spinothalamic tract plus spinotactile tract. Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so together the fiber, the bundle of this, okay, together called as the spinal lemniscus. Okay, in some book, okay, they have told that the fiber of anterior and the lateral spinothalamic together called as the spinal lemniscus. They have excluded the spinotactile, but in some book, okay, all these fiber together called as the spinal lemniscus. Are you getting? So
yes,
you
sir.
Got, you know about the now medial lemniscus, spinal lemniscus. Okay, similarly there is the trigeminal lemniscus also, lateral lemniscus also. Okay, that thing will come later. Okay, up to here. Now why spinotactile tract is required? So this spinotactile tract, so it forms the afferent pathway. Afferent pathway for spinovisual reflex. Spinovisual reflex. So is what is the need of this spinotactile tract? So for the spinovisual reflex. So it forms the afferent pathway. Okay. Efferent pathway will be formed by the tectospinal tract. That will come later. Okay. So it forms the afferent pathway. So what do you mean by spinovisual reflex? Now see, I'll give one example. See, if something is some stimuli, like if you have got some burn in your foot. Okay, so you are walking in the road, suppose. Okay, and you are walking in the road, suppose, and you suddenly keep your foot over the nail. Okay, are you getting? So then what will do? You will move your eye towards that side, isn't it? Where there is the stimuli, isn't it? Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So towards the site of stimuli, you will move your eye, isn't it? You will move your head, isn't it? To see that. So that is the actually spinovisual reflex. Okay. Where there is the stimuli, you will move your head to see that thing, isn't it? So that's the spinovisual reflex pathway. Okay, sir. Okay, so that is the spinal lemniscus. Now then, so at least you have to remember, for ascending tract at least you have to remember now dorsal column tract, spinothalamic tract, and the one more is there, spinocerebellar tract. At least you have to remember these three. Okay, this is spinotectile, they are the minor only. Similarly, there is the spinoreticular tract also. Okay, spinoolivary tract also there. Okay, now see. Okay, spinothalamic is over now. I'm not going to explain this. Okay, so okay, dorsal column tract also over. Now spinocerebellar tract is not over. Okay, now see this spinocerebellar tract. Now see this dorsal column tract. They act as your conscious level. Okay, because these the information carried by the dorsal column tract, it will reach in the your cerebral cortex. Okay, the spinocerebellar tract, it acts under subconscious and unconscious level. Okay, because see their information finally it will not reach in the cerebral cortex. Here they see the information from the musculoskeletal element, they are passed to the cerebellum. Here it will not pass to the cerebrum. Okay, it is passed to the cerebellum. Okay, so you are not aware of this thing. So here this spinocerebellar tract, it makes the efferent pathway for your maintenance of your balance and the equilibrium. Actually, are you getting? Because your cerebellum, so that is for the balancing center, coordination of the movement, that is from the help of cerebellum only. So posture maintenance, equilibrium maintenance, and the coordination of the movement. Okay, for this thing you need the help of the cerebellum. Are you getting? So this spinocerebellar tract, so first the information it should also pass to the cerebellum, isn't it, for this thing. So this pathway acts under the subconscious or unconscious level. Now see here what will happen. Now how the information it will go. So you have got a information. So what type of information? Proprioceptive information. Proprioceptive information, that is the information from the musculoskeletal element. I'll write directly here. So that means, so the sensation from the like tendon, joints, muscle, spindle, okay, like that. So these all information, so they are carried by the spinocerebellar tract also. See, this information is also carried by the dorsal column tract, isn't it? But they carry this information, so that is in the conscious level only. So the information carried by the dorsal column tract, that you will be aware of that information. But the information carried by the spinocerebellar tract, that is in subconscious and the unconscious level. You are not aware of this information. Okay. Now see, this spinocerebellar tract actually, so it extends between the, so it does not lie along the whole length of the spinal cord. Okay, so it extends in between, somewhere between the C8 to L2 to L3 spinal segment only. Okay, are you getting what I'm telling? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Only yes. This spinocerebellar tract, it extends between this spinal segment only, because see, we have got a 31 spinal segment. We have got a C7, C6, 5, 4, like this. Similarly, below here, see, after L3, there is L4, L5, S1, S2, like this, isn't it? But this spinocerebellar tract, you will find only in between this segment only. Okay, thus you have to remember this thing. So now we'll see the first order neuron, second order neuron, like that. Okay, let's see the, so information is okay. Now from where it is extend, that is okay. Now then we need the neurons. So since they are the afferent pathway only, so we have got the sensory neuron. So first order neuron, let's see the first order neuron. Then we'll see the next neuron. Okay, second order neuron we'll see. Okay. Now see here. So the first order neuron is same thing. So it lies on the ganglia of the dorsal nerve root ganglia. So that is in the spinal cord only. So the sensory neuron. So the first order neuron, so that is the dorsal nerve root ganglia, spinal cord. Cord. Now, okay. Then the next, see the second order neuron. Now see, for the second order neuron, see, which is the second order neuron for this spinocerebellar tract? Nucleus dorsalis, isn't it? So the nucleus dorsalis. So here, okay. So now we have got a two. So that is the anterior and anterior and posterior, ventral and dorsal, same thing. Okay, now see here. So we have got a two track. Now see here. Let me draw for you here first. Okay, here is the spinal cord is here. So because see these two spinocerebellar tract two are there. So ventral and dorsal is there. Out of this dorsal is ipsilateral, whereas the ventral is contralateral. Okay, now I have to solve this thing for you. So here is the posterior horn. Here is your ventral horn. Here is the ventral horn of next side, and here is the dorsal horn of the next side. So this is the gray matter only. So somewhere here, okay, you will find the Clark nucleus. That is the nucleus dorsalis, isn't it? So that from here, the second order neuron for the spinocerebellar tract will begin. Now see here. Suppose. So this is the right side. So this is the left side. So now see here. So the information, suppose it is coming, carrying here. There's the information that is carried under the subconscious or unconscious level. Okay. So this is the dorsal nerve root ganglia of the spinal cord. So that forms your first order neuron. Okay, first order sensory neuron. So it will relay in the Clark nucleus. Means from the Clark nucleus or the nucleus dorsalis, the second order neuron will begin. Now see, the second order neuron will be like this. Let me draw with the green color. So now nucleus dorsalis, this is the nucleus of second order neuron. Now from here, it will go in same side and run up. One condition is this. For the next, see, suppose the information is from left side. Okay, so the information is carried by this neuron under the subconscious and the unconscious level. So this is the first order neuron. It carries the information from the musculoskeletal element, and then it will relay in the Clark nucleus in the left side. Now the second order neuron, so it will begin from the Clark nucleus of the left side. Now it will cross the midline and it will go in the opposite side and it will run up. So this is the next condition. Okay, up to here, are you getting what I am making? Are you getting?
Sir, actually, if we explain Gardin now.
Okay, explain Garsuma. So here is the. Let me draw first. Okay, then I'll explain. Okay, so this is the dorsal. Here is the ventral. Similarly, here is the dorsal. In the next side also dorsal and ventral. So these two color, can you see this green color and blue color? So these are the two spinocerebellar tract. So okay, suppose this is the green. So this is one. Okay, similarly this is one in the next side. So this will be in both side. Okay, so ascending tract will be in both side. Both have same name. Okay. Here is the ventral. In next side also ventral. Okay, now see this first red color and the pink color fiber. Okay, suppose this red color fiber, so okay, in the left side. Okay, so this is the first order sensory neuron for the spinocerebellar tract. Now see, so it is carrying the information, that is the information from the musculoskeletal element, that you already know this thing. So now it is relaying in the Clark nucleus or nucleus dorsalis. Means the nucleus dorsalis, that is the cell body of second order neuron. Now see, if you see the green neuron here, so from the Clark nucleus of the left side, now it is moving on along the same side of the white column, isn't it? So this is moving on the same side from the left. So it is moving in the same side. So this is the spinal cerebellar tract. So this is now, this is the dorsal spinal cerebellar tract. So this dorsal spinal cerebellar tract, this is ipsilateral actually. So from the same side. Similarly, if information is from, if the information is coming from the, let me draw with the different color. So if information is coming from the right side, okay, so this is the first order neuron. So it will enter into the Clark nucleus of the same side. Now it will relay here. Then the next neuron, it will be like this. So second order neuron will begin. So now it will go in the same side. So this is now dorsal. So this is the dorsal spinocerebellar tract. So the dorsal spinocerebellar tract, they are ipsilateral. Okay, now if you see the pink, so pink is carrying the information. Now see from the dorsal column nucleus or the nucleus dorsalis, now the second order neuron is beginning, but it is crossing the midline and running along the fasciculus on the white fasciculus of the left side. So now this is the contralateral. So this is your anterior spinal cerebellar tract. So the anterior spinal cerebellar tract, that is contralateral, whereas the dorsal spinal cerebellar tract, that is ipsilateral. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me draw in this side also, then you will not have confusion. Now say, suppose this is carrying the information. Suppose now this is relaying the information here. Now the second order neuron beginning from this nucleus, suppose it is moving. So it is, second order neuron is beginning from the dorsal nucleus of the right side, but it is crossing to the opposite side and moving as a anterior spinal cerebellar tract. So anterior spinal cerebellar tract, they are carrying the information of the opposite side, whereas the dorsal spinal cerebellar tract, they are carrying the information of the same side, isn't it? Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir.
Now, finally, what is the target of this spinal cerebellar tract? That is the, what is the target?
Sir, to relay.
What is the destination?
Sir, cerebrum.
Cerebellum.
Sir, cerebellum.
See, here I have written the spinal cerebral tract. It is not spinal cerebral, it is spinal cerebellar. C-E-R-E-B-E-L-L-A-R. Okay,
yes, sir.
So the spelling is mistake here. What I am telling, that you listen, okay? Spinocerebellar tract, not spinocerebral tract, okay? So you should not copy what is there. So you have to listen what I am saying also, okay? So this is the spinocerebellar tract, not spinocerebral tract, okay? Are you getting? So the final destination, that is the cerebellum, not cerebrum. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now, okay. Suppose I'll write here now. So, cerebellum is here, okay. Now, this is the diagram of cerebellum, okay? Now, see here. Now the fiber is coming up. So now see, this green color fiber is coming, suppose. Now this green color fiber, see here, I'll extend this green color fiber now. So now, if you see the cerebellum also, so it has got a two hemisphere, right and left. Okay, so for that only I have found this partition here, okay? So this is the right, this is the left, okay? Now see, this green, first I saw the green color. Now this green color fiber is coming. Now it is entering here. Okay, are you getting here? Up to here? So this is the right half, right hemisphere. This is the left hemisphere. Okay, now see this anterior. So it is entering into the right. Suppose this is the right side. So this right is, this is entering to this right, isn't it? Now so, see here. So this, sorry, this is dorsal only. This dorsal, so it is entering in the cerebral hemisphere. But see, this dorsal, it is carrying the information from the same side. Now see, the information is carried from the right half and it is entering into the right hemisphere, isn't it? Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any confusion?
No, sir.
Now follow this. Follow in this side only. Don't see the left side now. See the right side. In the left side also, it will be same. See? So this green color, so this brown fiber, so first order neuron carrying the information, relaying with this green neuron, so that is from the Clark nucleus, then it run along with the same side, that is the lateral fasciculus or funiculus of the spinal cord as the dorsal spinocerebellar tract, and then finally it will enter into the right cerebral hemisphere. So from the right side it is entering to the right. That is okay. Now if you see the blue color fiber, so this blue color fiber is coming from the opposite side, isn't it? See this blue color fiber, so it is coming from opposite side. So it will also enter in the right cerebral, sorry, let me draw with the blue color. So it will also enter into the same cerebral hemisphere, but on entering the cerebral hemisphere, inside only it will cross and it will go to the opposite side. Because see, this blue color, it is carrying the information from the which side? Left side. So this information, it should go to the left cerebellum only, because this cerebellum, it has got a ipsilateral control. So it has got a ipsilateral control. Okay. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Cerebrum, it has got a contralateral, but the cerebellum, it has got a ipsilateral. Just you have to remember. Though this fiber, the fiber of the anterior spinocerebellar tract, it enter into the, so though it is entering into this cerebral hemisphere, but within the cerebellum it will cross and go to the opposite side. Okay, now the information from the left, it is going to the, now to the left, that is correct. Now so now see, now so now they are the bundles only. So see, this dorsal spinocerebellar tract, it enter into the cerebellum through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. You should know this thing now. Or the dorsal spinocerebellar tract, so it is carrying the information from the ipsilateral side, and it will enter to the cerebellum, okay, of same side through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So now this, that is the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So I'll write name here. So for the dorsal, this green color, so through the inferior cerebellar peduncle only it will enter. Inferior cerebellar peduncle. Are you getting? Now, if you see this blue color, so this blue color fiber, it is carrying the information from the contralateral side. Okay, this, that is the anterior spinocerebellar tract. So this anterior spinocerebellar tract, so it enter into the cerebellum through the superior cerebellar peduncle. So it enter into the cerebellum through the superior peduncle. On entering to the cerebellum, so then finally it will cross the midline and relay in the opposite side. Okay, are you getting? So they are the spinocerebellar tract. Okay.
Okay, sir. Cerebellum is contralateral and cerebellum is ipsilateral, yes, sir.
Huh?
Cerebellum is contralateral.
Cerebellum, huh? See, cerebellum is ipsilateral only. See. Just forget now this thing. Now see here. So this is the, so suppose this is the right, this is the left, isn't it? So
yes.
In case of cerebrum, because I'll write here and I will tell. So it will not be confusion for you. Now first, that is for cerebrum, okay? So cerebrum, okay. Now see, the information from the right side, it will go to the left. And the right side is controlled by the left. Similarly, the information from the left side, it will go to the right. And the right side will control the left. That is in case of, that is cerebrum for this. Okay. In case of cerebellum, the information from the right, it should go to the right cerebral hemisphere. cerebellar hemisphere. In case of left, the information it should go to the left cerebellar hemisphere. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So cerebrum, that is contralateral, whereas the cerebellum, so it has got the ipsilateral. Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir.
So means information from the left, it should go to the left. Anyone is
dorsal root, dorsal nerve with ganglia fossa other neuron. Euta chai muscle ko lagi, euta chai skeleton ko lagi rakhnu bhayo. Fossa other neuron. त्यो जुन त्यो पोस्टेरियर हर्नमा आइरहेको छ नि त्यो दुईटा चाहिँ किन राख्नु भयो
दुईटा तपाईँहरूलाई डोर्सल एन्ड द वेन्ट्रल स्पाइनल सेरेबेलर ट्र्याक बताउनको लागि राखेको कि सो ओन्ली वान न्युरोन इट विल नट क्यारी देयर विल बी द बन्डल अफ न्युरोन विल बी देयर जस्ट आई हेभ सन द वान ओन्ली ओके दे विल बी इन बन्डल ओन्ली ओन्ली वान न्युरोन इज नट क्यारिङ दिस इन्फर्मेसन ओके
Sure.
Means you are thinking that only one neuron will carry this all information? No. So there will be the multiple neuron will be there. So there may be the many neuron. They are carrying this information. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sir. Sir, anterior dorsal is same type of information carry sir.
Yeah,
so that information means the information from the musculoskeletal element. So musculoskeletal element means muscle, bone, joints, these all thing, tendon. Okay, so to make you understand, only I have made this only two neurons. So there will be many, isn't it? So many parts are there in the body, isn't it? So they will carry the, say, from thumb, sorry, from the greater toe to the up to the level of neck, they have to carry the this information, isn't it? So muscles are there, bones are there, joints are there, tendons are there, isn't it? So many neuron will be there. Thus I have made the two. Okay, two saw the anterior and the posterior spinocerebellar tract. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Now what I have explained, the same thing is there. Now see here. So see here. So they are the, we see the proprioceptive information, that is the information from the muscles, joint, bone, tendon, ligament. So same thing is this. So they are proprioceptive information. Okay, whatever the information is that from the musculoskeletal element, they are the proprioceptive only. So this information, now see here. So they are carried here. So if you see the red fiber, see, now it is running along the same side and it will form the dorsal spinocerebellar tract. Then finally it this is the inferior cerebellar peduncle actually. Okay, so through this it will enter into the same side of the cerebellar hemisphere. Okay, now see, if you see the blue color fiber, so this is carrying the same information, so but it is crossing and going to the opposite and making the ventral or the anterior spinocerebellar tract. Now it will enter along the through the superior cerebellar peduncle to the cerebellum, and it will cross within that only. See, it is coming from the right. Okay, after entering into the cerebral hemisphere, it will go to the left within the cerebellum only. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Are you getting? So the same thing is this. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, anterior or posterior, same type of information carry or sir, ki different?
Same information. Proprioceptive information means proprioceptive. That is the same.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So if you read the cerebellum, means you will got to know. So the main function is, three functions are there. So maintenance of the equilibrium, then the coordination of the movement, and the next is the postural maintenance. So for this, here is the role of cerebellum. So now cerebellum alone it is not going to do. So there is the collaboration with the vestibular system of the inner ear also, and there is the collaboration with the basal ganglia also, and there is the collaboration with the cortex also. So only one part of the brain, it may not perform all the function. Okay, they will take the collaboration or the mutual help of each other. to perform the this function. Okay. Are you getting?
Sir.
Now one more thing I have to tell.
Dorsal cerebral tract, say cerebellum, inferior cerebral peduncle vata jancha and your ventral say cerebellum superior cerebral peduncle
vata. Cerebellar peduncle vata jancha.
Ibada say inferior vata say or ku say superior vata.
Superior cerebellar peduncle. Now see here. Now I'll tell about the cerebellar peduncle. Okay. So the actually that thing, this peduncle, it will come while you will read the cerebellum. Okay, though I'll tell here. Now see here. So you have got a three pair of the cerebellar peduncle, the superior, medial, inferior. Okay, on the both sides, right and left. Okay, so this superior cerebellar peduncle helps to connect the cerebellum with the midbrain. Medial cerebellar peduncle, it helps to connect the cerebellum with pons. Inferior cerebellar peduncle, it helps to connect the cerebellum with medulla. Just you remember this thing. Okay, so midbrain, pons, medulla. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Sir,
this going
to be as a bandhana, sir. So superior cerebellar peduncle, it connects the cerebellum with midbrain. Okay, this is just basic only. It consists of various fiber. Okay, so various efferent and afferent fiber, that it will come while reading the cerebellum. Okay, just you remember. So the medial cerebellar peduncle, it helps to connect the cerebellum with pons. Inferior, it helps to connect the cerebellum with medulla. Means cerebellum is connected with medulla with help of inferior. Cerebellum is connected with the pons with help of middle. Cerebellum is connected with midbrain with help of superior. That thing okay. I was telling. Okay, just remember this thing. Okay. Now. Okay. So this is the now one more thing I was telling actually. Okay. So see, this spinal cerebellar tract, it does not extend along the whole length of the spinal cord, isn't it? So almost C8 to L5. So that thing I have already told. So now see, from L2 to L3, okay? So it is not, okay, so it is extended between this. Now see, we have got a spinal segment below L2 also, isn't it? So below L2 means we have got a, or below L3 means we have got a L4, L5, L6, isn't it? So we have got a L4, we have got a L5, isn't it? So similarly, we have got a S1 to S5, and we have got a coccygeal 1, isn't it? So now see, from this also the information will come, isn't it? But this tract, it does not extend below this, then how this information just below the level of L2, L3, they will come. Cerebellar tract, so it does not extend along the whole length of the spinal cord, isn't it? So from C8 to almost at the level of L2, L3 only it will extend. Now see, so the information, so from below the level of L2, L3, okay? There is also the spinal nerve is also there. So they will also carry the proprioceptive information. So now how they will be carried by the spinal cerebellar tract, I was telling. Now see here. Suppose this is the posterior median septum. So posterior white column, lateral white column, anterior white column. So this is the anterior median fissure. Similarly in the next side also. Okay, so this is your spinal cord. So this is the posterior gray column, anterior gray column, posterior gray horn. Okay. So here is the central canal. Okay. Suppose this is the spinal, one spinal segment. Let's say it is the L1. Okay. L1 is spinal segment. Let me draw here one more spinal segment. Okay. So posterior median septum. Lateral funiculus, anterior funiculus, anterior median fissure. Similarly, here is the posterior white column, lateral white column, anterior white column. Then here is the posterior horn, anterior horn, anterior horn, and the posterior horn of the neck side. Okay, here is the central canal. Now see, suppose this is the S2. Okay, so L1 is there, L2, L3, L4. Sorry, L1, L2, L3, L4, L5, then S1, S2. Okay, so this is the two spinal segment. Now see here. So spinocerebellar tract. So up to L1, there is spinocerebellar tract is there. Now see. Now, suppose this neuron is carrying the information, proprioceptive information from the musculoskeletal element. Okay, then it is entering into the posterior horn through the posterior lateral sulcus, then relay into the nucleus dorsalis. Then from here, either there is the beginning of the dorsal spinocerebellar tract, that is the ipsilateral, or anterior spinocerebellar tract, that is the contralateral. That is okay, isn't it? So, but see, in S2, there is no spinocerebellar tract, isn't it? Then how the information will come? Now see here. So suppose this is carrying the, let me draw with the different color so that it, you will understand. Now suppose this is the blue color. Okay, now see, suppose this is the neuron carrying the proprioceptive information, that is the information from the musculoskeletal element. Then it will enter into the dorsal column tract directly through the, with the help of medial root of the sensory, that is the medial sensory root. Okay, so the sensory, it has got a two root, medial and the lateral. So if they enter from the medial root, they directly enter into the posterior column tract and they will ascend up. Okay, now I will give the dot dot. So they will ascend up. So now they will reach the posterior column of the L1. Now see, now from here they will give the collateral. Okay, then from here now the track will continue, because there is no spinocerebellar tract in S2. So from here they cannot give. So the information is carried up to the level of L1, L2, and the collateral is given. So the information is carried along the dorsal column tract. Then the collateral is given to the nucleus dorsalis. Then from here there is the spinocerebellar tract. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So means, see, spinocerebellar tract you will find in this spinal segment up to L2 or L3 you will get, but below you will not get the spinocerebellar tract. Okay. So let me draw here. Suppose here is the spinocerebellar tract. So dorsal spinocerebellar tract, ventral spinocerebellar, and the next is the ventral spinocerebellar tract. Suppose this is two spinocerebellar tract. Here also, in this side also, dorsal and ventral. Okay, for your understanding only, I am making this. So, but you will not find the spinocerebellar tract here. So, the information, see, there is the, just below the L1, L2 or L3, there is also a spinal nerve is present. This spinal nerve also carries this information. So, this information, so there is no spinocerebellar tract. Beginning of spinocerebellar tract is not there, just below the L2, L3 spinal segment. So this information carried just below this level, they are carried along the dorsal column tract. Then finally, as they reach at the level of L2, L3 or L1, so they will give collateral to the nucleus dorsalis. Then from here, they are carried to the cerebellum. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now one more thing. Next is the cuneocerebellar tract. Next is the spinoolivary tract. Spinoolivary spinal olivary tract. So yeah, like here. Okay, spinal olivary tract. Now see here. Now these two tracts. So see, this spinal olivary tract actually it forms the indirect pathway. Okay, of spinal cerebellar tract only. Okay, this spinal olivary tract also carries the same type of information. Okay, before reaching to the cerebellum, so it will relay in the olivary nucleus, that is the inferior olivary nucleus in the medulla. Then from the medulla, the inferior olivary nucleus to the cerebellum, it will go. Okay, through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. Now see here, let me show you here. Suppose, see here, so suppose here, this is the segment of spinal cord. Now I am making the spinal olivary tract here. Now I'll draw from the right side now here, see, let me draw with the different color, so brown color, okay. So see here, so the neuron that is carrying the information, so the okay, brown color I have to draw. So the same information it is carrying. Okay, so now see here, so proprioceptive information only they are carrying. Okay, now see here, from here it will go to the, now it will relay here. Now from here it will again move to the opposite side and go up. Okay, now it will not directly enter into the cerebellum. Okay, by the help of inferior cerebellum only it will enter, but before that it will relay in the one nucleus. So suppose here is the, let me draw the medulla here. Suppose this is the medulla. Okay, suppose this is the medulla here. Okay, now see here, so here you will find the inferior olivary nucleus. Okay, so this is the inferior olivary nucleus. So see, this spinal olivary tract, it forms the alternate pathway or indirect pathway for the spinal cerebellar tract. Because you remember this thing. So it carries the same information, proprioceptive information only. So it will relay in the posterior horn. Now from the posterior horn, the second order neuron will begin and it will run along the contralateral side. Now finally, it will relay in the olivary nucleus. Now it is relaying here. Now from the olivary nucleus, now the next order neuron will begin. Now from here, so the next order neuron, let me draw with the red color. So here is the cell body. Now from here it will move and it will go inside the, okay, I cannot draw above. Okay, so now move inside the cerebellum. So suppose this is the cerebellum. So now this is going to the opposite side. So through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So this is the right side only. Okay, so here is the left half of the cerebellar hemisphere, suppose. Now see, from here it is moving to the opposite side, so that is the right side here. Okay, through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So this is the inferior cerebellar peduncle only. Are you getting? So inferior olivary nucleus is there. Nucleus. So in the medulla, so first it will relay in the medulla, so lower part of the medulla, then from the inferior olivary nucleus to the cerebellum via inferior cerebellar peduncle. Now see, so information is coming from the right side, so this track is crossing. Okay, so next order neuron, so it is moving to the contralateral side. So that is the spinal olivary tract. Again, from the, on reaching the inferior olivary nucleus, so again, it will go to the opposite side. This is the third order neuron and it will relay to the cerebellum. So through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So from right to right. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just you remember this thing. The spinal olivary tract, it forms the indirect pathway for the spinal cerebellar tract. Okay, just you remember this. Okay, just basic information for this minor tract, that is sufficient for you. Okay, just you have to remember the dorsal column tract, spinothalamic tract, spinal cerebellar tract. Okay, in the ascending tract. At least you have to remember this tract. Okay, other are minor tract. Now the next, see here, let me clear this diagram first. Okay, now the cuneocerebellar tract. Okay, now the cuneocerebellar tract. Okay, now this L1, S2 is not required here. Okay, so now see, just see this is twist spinal segment. Now see here. So the cuneocerebellar tract. So you know the dorsal column tract, isn't it? So see this blue color here. So it is carrying the proprioceptive information. It also carrying the fine touch and pressure sensation, vibration sensation to when discrimination tip touch. This all thing it is carried by this fiber dorsal column tract. Now see this dorsal column tract as it reaches the lower part of the medulla. Okay, in the lower part of the medulla. Okay, let me draw here medulla. So fasciculus gracilis, fasciculus cuneatus. Okay, suppose this is the medulla, one half of the medulla. Similarly, there is the next half of the medulla. Okay, close part of the medulla. So here is the nucleus. So gracile nucleus is here. Cuneate nucleus is here in the lower part of the medulla. Similarly, in this side also, nucleus is here. Now see this blue color tract. So this is the dorsal column tract is moving up. Okay, just I am making for one neuron only here. So this dorsal column tract is moving up. So it is carrying this all the information, proprioceptive information, fine touch and pressure, vibration sensation, and the 2-point discrimination. Okay, now see it is moving up. Then finally, so it will reach here. So then from here it will enter here. Okay, now it will relay in the cuneate nucleus. This is laterally is cuneate, medially is the gracile. Similarly, so gracile also it will reach here. Gracile nucleus is not required for us. Now see the information is reached here. Now from the cuneate nucleus, the second order neuron will begin, that you know already. So from here second order neuron will begin. Now they will cross and they will go up. Similarly, from this also, they will come here and they will go up. Okay, from the opposite side, from here it will come here and it will go up. The opposite side. So that is I am not drawing that thing. Now see, this is the cuneate nucleus. So the fiber, okay, from the cuneate nucleus or from cuneate nucleus, some fiber, okay. So it will go to the cerebellum. Okay, are you getting? So this is the cuneocerebellar fiber or the cuneocerebellar tract. Are you getting? So here is the cerebellum. So through the inferior cerebellar peduncle, so from the cuneate nucleus, okay, some fiber, it will go to the cerebellum through the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So this is the cuneocerebellar fiber or the cuneocerebellar tract. Okay, so this is also known as external, that is posterior external arcuate fiber. Okay, so here see, so from cuneate nucleus to cerebellum via the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So this fiber will go here to the cerebellum. So this is the cuneocerebellar fiber or the cuneocerebellar tract. Let's you remember this thing. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Then okay, so spinocerebellar tract, that is over now. Okay. Now we'll see the descending tract. The name of the descending tract you know already, isn't it?
Yes,
or you don't know? Okay. So the first we'll read the one descending tract. That is the corticospinal tract we'll read. Okay. Now see, name only suggests that corticospinal tract. So beginning is from the cortex. The cortex of the cerebrum. So that is the motor cortex of the cerebrum. Some fiber will come from the primary. Okay, most of the fiber from the primary and from the secondary. Then some fiber from the sensory cortex also it will come here. Okay, so that is the corticospinal. Then finally target is the spinal cord. Okay, from where it will influence the lower motor neuron. Okay. Now we have to see all these things. Now, see corticospinal is sensory fiber or motor? Which type of fiber is this? Or which type of track is this?
Motor.
Okay. So it has got upper motor and the lower motor neuron there, isn't it? While reading the ascending track, we have read the sensory neuron. So first order, second order, third order, like that. Now we are reading the descending. So we'll read the upper motor neuron, lower motor neuron, like that. Okay. So the upper motor neuron will begin from the cortex. Next, upper motor neuron terminate in the spinal cord. Lower motor neuron will begin from the spinal cord, like that. Okay, so the corticospinal tract, it will influence the lower motor neuron. Okay, now see here. So, corticospinal tract. So, beginning is from the cortex. Okay. See, while typing, spelling may be mistake, okay? Just you write the correct spelling only, okay? So I have to speak and I have to write type also, na? So, okay? So see,
okay.
So the beginning of the corticospinal tract, that is from the cerebral cortex. So cortex means cortex, that is the cortex is formed by the gray matter only. So the cell body lies in this cortex. So if you see the cerebrum, so the outer cortex, there is the gray matter is there. Okay, then inside there is the white matter. Okay, then within that white matter also some gray matter are there. So they forms the basal ganglia actually. Okay, now see here cerebral cortex, that is the so motor cortex here. Okay, mostly from the motor cortex. So motor cortex, see, so just in front of the central sulcus. Okay, the all the area that is the motor area only. Just behind the central sulcus, the area they are the sensory. So the this fiber they will begin from just in front of the central sulcus. So especially that is the precentral gyrus. Okay, just I will write here. So that is the primary motor area. Area, secondary motor area. Okay, and some fiber may come from the sensory also, okay, area number 1, 3 and 2 also, okay, just now here you remember the motor area. Now the fiber, they are coming from the motor area. So this, that means that is the motor cortex as well here. Cerebrum, just you remember this thing. So, see, while writing the name of descending tract, I have given the two headings. Isn't it? Pyramidal tract and extra pyramidal tract, isn't it? So
yes, sir.
This corticospinal tract, they are the pyramidal tract. Because the cell body, this tract began from the pyramidal cell. Pyramidal cell. Okay, so they are the pyramidal tract. Okay, here is the extra pyramidal also. This extra pyramidal tract, they does not begin from the cortex. They begin from other cell, okay? Not from the pyramidal cell. So one reason for calling the corticospinal tract as the pyramidal tract, because the beginning is from the pyramidal cell. Okay, the cell body has got a pyramid inside. Okay, just you remember. So the pyramidal cell you will find in the motor cortex. Okay, just remember this thing. Now see what happened. So from the cortex, so it carries the motor information, isn't it? So now from cortex, it will descend down. So from where it will descend? Now see here. So it descends along the corona radiata. Then along the internal capsule. Internal capsule. Then see. Now midbrain will come. So from the cross cerebri of the midbrain. Actually middle 3/5 part of the cross cerebri. Okay. Cross cerebri. Then so it again descend down. So along the basilar part of the pons. Okay. Just you can write pons. Pons. Then again it descend along the pyramid of the medulla. Now in the lower part of the pyramid, what will happen? So this fiber, see the most of the fiber, they will cross each other. They will cross and they will go to the contralateral side. Most of the fiber. So in the lower part of the medulla, okay, on the lower part of the medulla or the lower part of the pyramid. Of the pyramid, so the fiber deposit. So the most of the fiber, more than 80% of the fiber, they will cross each other. Okay, so they will go to the opposite side. The 80% of the fiber, okay, and contralaterally, but the remaining 20% of the fiber, they does not cross, they will pass ipsilaterally. Okay, after writing this I will explain for you. Then the 20% let's say 20% here, so the 20% now they will not cross. Okay, so they will not cross, so they will move. Ipsilaterally. Now see here. So after crossing, so this 80% of fiber after crossing, they forms the lateral corticospinal tract. So they move along the lateral funiculus of the contralateral half of the spinal cord. Whereas the 20% which is not crossing, which is not going to opposite side, they will move along the anterior funiculus. Okay, just on the either side of the midline, they will run. Okay, so they will run ipsilaterally from the anterior funiculus or anterior white column of the spinal cord in same side, whereas the 80% they are crossing, so they will move to the opposite side. So the opposite side of the, they will run along the lateral funiculus of the opposite half of the spinal cord. Okay, as a lateral corticospinal tract, whereas the 20% they run along the anterior funiculus of the ipsilateral half of the spinal cord as the anterior corticospinal tract. So they forms the anterior corticospinal tract. And this contralaterally moving fiber, so they run along the lateral funiculus of the spinal cord on the contralateral side. So they forms the lateral cortical tract. Are you getting? Then finally, see this lateral corticospinal tract that is already crossed. Then, but the see this anterior, it is not crossed. So now this anterior also it will cross on its respective spinal segment. So before influencing the lower motor neuron, it will cross to the opposite side. Okay. So they also finally they will also cross. Okay. Cross along the anterior white commissure. Right. So are you getting up to here? So this cortical spinal tract that is important only. Okay.
Sir.
Okay, up to here. Okay for you. No confusion. No need to show in diagram.
Sir.
No confusion for me.
Okay. For remaining, maybe they are not there.
The diagram में देखाऊँ ना.
So up here, okay. This is in word only. So this corticospinal tract that is very very important only. Okay, if they ask in viva also they may ask. Okay. Okay, then I'll show in the diagram. Now see here. So before that, see. So it begins from the cortex. Now see here. So in the cortex, see in the motor. See initially you have seen the sensory homunculus, isn't it? Now similarly there is the motor homunculus also. Okay, in the motor cortex means. So see in the motor cortex area. Okay, see. For hand, there is the more neuron is coming for the hand. Okay, so there is the more area, motor area for the hand in the motor cortex. Okay, similarly in the trunk and the forearm and the arm, so there are few neurons, so the area is less. Okay, so you can see here, so distorted picture of human body you can see here. So see, hand is large here, isn't it? Because the motor area, so the motor cortex, the area in the motor cortex that is larger in case of hand. Okay, similarly for the tongue, and tongue also the area is large, because see tongue, it has got a function in speaking also. Okay, articulation of the voice. Okay, so movement should be there, so there is a more area for the tongue. Okay, similarly for the hand. Okay, so just I'll show one diagram for you here. Okay, see here. See in the right hand side. So this is for the, this is the motor homunculus. Means there is a certain area of the cortex is there. So that motor cortex, so the neuron of the motor cortex, they are coming more for the hand. See, the area of hand is large here. Means the area in the motor cortex controlling the movement of hand is more. Okay. See, in compare with the hand. See the forearm and the arm, this is less, so the area is less, so neuron they are less in the motor cortex. See similarly in the jaw, tongue, so the area is more. So see, so for this area the neuron from the motor cortex is more. Similarly in the foot the area is more, but see in the trunk and this, so neuron from the motor cortex they are less. So that is actually, this is the motor homunculus. So this motor homunculus, that is the area of the cortex, it is not proportional to the size of your body part. Okay, actually this area of the motor cortex is directly proportional to the precise movement, okay, that is going to be performed by your body part. See the movement of your hand. See, it can do the very precise and accurate movement. See the writing movement, isn't it? So that is very precise. So for this precise movement, there should be more area for the in the motor cortex, isn't it? Similarly in speaking also, so there should be accurate movement should be there, isn't it? Accurate movement of the lip, jaw, teeth should be there, isn't it? So there should be the more area to control this. So the area will be more for this. Similarly for the foot also. Are you getting? So the area of the cortex, okay, it is not proportional to the size of your body part. So see, if you see the size of the body part, so it is large than the hand, but the area controlling for the hand is more larger than the area in the motor cortex controlling the trunk. Though the trunk is large, there is no large area in the motor cortex to control the trunk. Okay, so the area is directly proportional to the precise movement, okay, that is going to perform by your body part, okay, or the fine movement they are going to perform by your body part. So which part is going to do the fine movement or precise, very precise movement or very accurate movement for that body part, the area on the motor cortex is large. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that is the first point. Okay, for the corticospinal tract, because they begin from the motor cortex. Okay, so you have to know the motor homunculus. Means the motor cortex. So area is larger for those body part which is going to do the very fine or the very precise and the very accurate movement. Okay, that is the first point. Now we will see the course of the track. Now let me draw the. Let me take the one blank page. Okay, wait. Okay. Now beginning of the track is okay. So that is the cortex. So the cortex. So there is the motor homunculus is there. Do you know this thing? Now let me draw the cortex. Suppose here is your right hemisphere and here is the left hemisphere. Okay, just for your understanding only, I am making this. Okay. So it is very difficult to draw the brain here, okay, by this computer. So now see here. So beginning is from the cortex. So from the pyramidal cell it will begin. So suppose this is the. Now let me draw the upper motor neuron. So now beginning is from here. Okay. So suppose this is the pyramidal cell. So now axon is beginning here. So they will run down. Okay. So from the next half also they will move down. So this is the suppose this is the motor cortex. So motor cortex is just in front of the central sulcus. Okay, so area number 4. Okay, so it's the motor cortex. Now see here. Now they are moving down. Now see while moving down, so they move along the corona radiata, then through the internal capsule, then finally it will reach to the midbrain. Now I draw the outline of midbrain. I can draw here. Now see here the plus. Okay, so rectum, crus cerebri. Similarly, next half of the crus cerebri. Okay, midbrain. So here is the cerebral aqueduct is here. So this is the crus cerebri. So this is the crus cerebri. Okay. So now crus cerebri, I am dividing into three regions. So lateral, middle, and the okay. So middle, lateral, and the medial. This is the middle. So middle, 3/5 part. So from here only it will move. Let me draw the neuron with the green color. Okay. So see here. So it is moving. So along the corona radiata, internal capsule. Then it run along the medial, 3/5 of the crus cerebri. So this part of the midbrain, that is the crus cerebri. Let me write here. So this is the crus cerebri. Crus cerebri. So this is the actually it is running along the middle one, middle 3/5 part of the crus cerebri or the middle part of the crus cerebri. Now, so it is this now it to the pons. Now I'll draw the pons here. So see here, this is the basilar part of the pons. Okay, so this is the medial cerebellar peduncle. So now it will go to the cerebellum. So this is the basilar part of the pons. Okay, in front also there is the region of pons is here. Okay, now here you will see the pontine nucleus. You will see here. So these are the pontine nucleus. Pontine nucleus. So pontine nucleus. So these are in the basilar part. You see the pontine nucleus. Okay, so that is not required here. Now see here. So now your cortical spinal tract is running down. So they will not relay here. Okay, they are single only. So this is the axon. Now they will pass from here. Now they will pass from the basilar part of the pons also. Now here we will find the bundle of the cortical spinal tract. So similarly here is the bundle. So here is the bundle of the cortical spinal tract. Okay, so intermixed with the pontine nucleus. So these all are the cortical spinal tract, bundle of the cortical spinal tract. Okay, so this is the inferior, see this is the middle cerebellar peduncle, that is not required here. So this is the pons. Now in the medulla, so if you see in the medulla, so this is the pyramid of the medulla. In the back side you will see